Hey there, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we're going to do some subtraction with regrouping, but this time there's zeros in the tens and hundreds place. It's tricky, but we can do it. Make sure you already know how to do regrouping with 2 and 3 digit numbers. So here we're subtracting 404 and 36. Let's start by writing this problem out vertically. We need to make sure we line up our place values. So we'll write 404, and then we don't have a hundreds place in this one. So our tens place goes in the tens and our ones in the ones. Perfect. So what do? Yep, we subtract in the ones column first. And what do you notice about this problem? That's right, we already need to borrow because 4 is smaller than 6. So I'm gonna go next door to my tens place and oh my gosh, what do we have? A 0. So we can't borrow from the 0. So we need to go over to the next neighbor in our hundreds place, the 4. We're gonna borrow from this 4. So we're gonna take 100 from here. So this is gonna be 3. Remember, this is 300 because this is our hundreds column. And I'm gonna give 100 over here to my tens place. So this 0 is now going to be a 10 because a 10 in the tens place means 100. Perfect. But I still need to borrow to be able to do my subtraction in the ones place. So I'm back to this 10. I'm going to take one of the 10. So now I have just 9 and I'm giving the 10 to my 1. So 10 plus 4, that gives me 14. So 14 minus 6, that gives me 8, and then I have 9 minus 3, that gives me 6, and then I have 3 minus, there's a 0 here, so 3 minus 0 is 3. 368 is our answer. Good work. Okay, next problem is 500 minus 289. So we'll write it vertically, lining up our place values. So we have 500 minus 289. Okay. So right away, what are we going to do? Yeah, we're starting in our ones column, but we have 0 minus 9, which we definitely can't do. So we need to borrow. I'm going to go next door to the tens place, but I have another 0. So right away, I have to go all the way to the hundreds place. I'm going to take 100 from my hundreds column. So this will give me a 4. So I have 4 in my hundreds column. And then I'm giving that 100 over here to my tens place. So this will give me a 10 in the tens place. So that's 100, remember? But I still need to borrow again. So I'm going to take one of these. This gives me 9. I'm giving that 10 over here. So this 0 becomes a 10. So I got 10 in the ones. 10 minus 9, that leaves me with 1. And I have 9 minus 8, that also leaves me with a 1. And then 4 minus 2, that will give me 2. So my answer here is 211. Good job. Okay, we've got this last example here we're going to do all together. And it says 903 minus 564. So I'm going to line up my place values. I have 903 and then 564. Okay, I'm subtracting these here. So what place do I start in? Yeah, the ones place. It says 3 minus 4. Can we do that? No. So we need to go over to the tens place and borrow, but we have a 0 here. So what do we have to do? Yep, we have to go over to the hundreds place and we borrow. So if I have a 9 here and I'm going to borrow 100, this will give me an 8. So I have 800 here in my hundreds place. And I'm giving that 100 here to my tens place. But what do I do when I'm giving 100 over? My tens place is a 10. Okay. So what do? I still need to give this guy a 10. So I'm going to take it from my tens column now. So I have 9 here and I'm giving that 10 here. So I have 10 plus 3. This will give me 13. And 13 minus 4, that's 9. 9 minus 6, that is 3. And 8 minus 5, that is also 3. So our answer is 339. Good job. Woohoo! Now you can subtract big numbers, even when they have zeros in the ones and tens place. Do some practice on your own, have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey.